excited for tonight's production of Out of Joint Hamlet with Bread and Puppet.
Yay!
Peter came into the theater in January and walked through that door. His eyes immediately went up, and he looked, and you could see the wheels turning, and he said, "I have it." And now here we are, and you get to see what he has, and it's going to be awesome.
Tonight's show is the totally out of joint Hamlet show. And the first scene is the Hamlet symbol. Thank you.
scholar. Speak to it.
It harrows me with fear and wonder. What art thou that usurpest this time of night?
It is offended. Stay.
Oh, speak, speak.
His cannon against self-slaughter. Oh God! Oh God!
Hamlet is thinking aloud. He speaks as in a dream, but the dream is a nightmare, the full meaning of which we do not realize until the last three lines.
How weary, stale, flat and unprofitable seem to me all the uses of this world. A fie on it. Oh, fie! 'Tis an unweeded garden that grows to seed. Things rank and gross in nature possess it merely.
His mind turns and turns upon itself in an effort to escape giving birth to the monster in his thoughts.
It is not, nor it cannot, come to good. But break my heart, for I must hold my tongue.
Thank you. not.
I do beseech you.
I know no pleasure, my lord.
Oh, it is as easy as lying. Govern these vantages with your fingers and thumb. Give it breath with your mouth, and it will discord most eloquent music. Look you, these are the stops.
But these I cannot command to any utterance of harmony. I have not the skill.
Oh, why, look you now. How unworthy a thing you make of me. You would play upon me. You would seem to know my stops. You would look at the heart of my mystery, and there is much music to this little organ. Yet cannot you make it speak? Do you think I am easier to be played on than a pipe? Call me what instrument you will, though you can fret me, yet you cannot play upon me.
God bless you, sir. My lord, the queen would speak with you, and presently.
Do you see yonder cloud that's almost in shape of a camel?
Yes, by the mass, and 'tis like a camel indeed, yes.
Methinks it is like a weasel.
Yes, it is that like a weasel.
More like a whale.
Very like a whale.
Then I will come to my mother by and by. They fool me to the top of my bent.
I will say so.
By and by is easily said.
Yes.
I will come by and by.
Yes, bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Thank you. dimension, how like a god. The beauty of the world, the paragon of animals. And yet, to me, what is this quintessence of dust?
Thank you.
made. Reality twice.
Against me and spur my dull revenge. What is a man if his chief good and market of his time be but to sleep and feed? A beast, no more.
Part of that is when they try and demean me unfairly because we had a massive crowd of people. We had a crowd. I looked over that sea of people, and I said to myself, wow.
Surely he that made us with such large discourse, looking before and after, gave us not that capability and godlike reason to fust in us unused.
Sorry, losers and haters, but my IQ is one of the highest in all known. Please don't feel so stupid or insecure. It's not your fault.
A thought, which, quartered, hath but one part wisdom and ever three parts coward.
They will be met with fire and fury and, frankly, power, the likes of which this world has never seen before.
I see the imminent death of 20,000 men, that for a fantasy and trick of fame go to their graves like beds, fight for a plot whereon the numbers cannot try the cause, which is not tomb enough and continent to hide the slain.
We're rounding them up in a very humane way, in a very nice way, and they're going to be happy because they want to be legalized. And by the way, I know it doesn't sound nice, but not everything is nice.
Oh, from this time forth, my thoughts be bloody, or nothing worth.
I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody, and I wouldn't lose any voters, okay? It's, like, incredible.
Oh, so sad.
and shows his hoar leaves in the glassy stream. There, with fantastic garlands, did she come, of crow flowers, nettles, daisies, and long purples that liberal shepherds give a grosser name, but our cold maids do dead man's fingers call them. There, on the pendant boughs, her coronet weeds clambering to hang, an envious sliver broke, went down her weedy trophies, and herself fell in the weeping brook. Her clothes spread wide, and mermaid-like, a while they bore her up, which time she chanted snatches of old tunes, as one incapable of her own distress, or like a creature native and endued unto that element. But long it could not be, till that her garments, heavy with their drink, pulled the poor wretch from her melodious lay to muddy death.
She drowned herself.
Nay,
Give me leave. Here lies the water.
Okay.
And there stands the man. If the man go to this water,
okay, I'm going.
And drown himself, it is will he, nil he goes.
Blah, 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 blah.
Mark you that. But if the water come to him and drown him, he drowns not himself. Argal, he that is not guilty of his own death shortens not his own life.
But is this law?
Aye, Mary, 'tis Crowner's quest law.
Will you have the truth on it? If this had not been a gentlewoman, she should have been buried out, O Christian burial.
Well, go get us some more beer.
Whose grave's this, sirrah? What man dost thou dig it for?
For no man, sir.
What woman, then?
For none, neither.
Who is to be buried in it?
One that was a woman, but rest her soul, sir, she's dead.
Soft now, here comes the king.
Ta-ta-ta-ta!
We want to thank our all-volunteer cast for making this show possible.